which, you know, honestly, I haven't played this game a ton of times compared to the first two Mega Man X games, but I've played it enough to figure out, you know, how to get all this shit in the game and beat the game and only die maybe once or twice, so I think I've accomplished something. So, I'm coming back to this stage for two reasons. One, because I need that sub-tank at the end of the stage for 100%. And two, this is where the stage is where you can fight Vile. Now, the reason why I'm fighting Vile now and why I didn't fight him earlier is because, apparently, if you kill Vile using in a stage where the boss hasn't been defeated yet, then escaping from this, you know, subterranean mine will be more difficult. So it's easier to wait until you've beaten a boss and then come back and do it. So that's what I'm doing. And once again, Vile has the same conventions as Bit and Bite, where if you want to beat him for good, you have to use a very specific item to kill him with. However, you're trapped, X. Zero and I destroyed you years ago. This factory is set to blow in a matter of minutes. Notice how he completely dismissed the question. He's just like, I thought I killed you. And he's like, yeah, this factory's gonna explode, so I'm gonna kick your ass until we all die. Well, you didn't address how I you shouldn't even exist. Why are you here? So he's doing the thing where he's just gonna charge at you and hit the walls to knock you off, but it's no problem. So I have his weakness. His weakness is the Ray Sparkler. But killing him with the Ray Sparkler and then, you know, obviously he's gonna do the thing that we all know he's gonna do, where he's gonna jump out of his armor and fight us one-on-one with completely regenerated life. If I beat both him and the right armor with the Ray Sparkler, I won't have enough to finish him off. So that's why I did this. I mean, you could do it, I think. Actually, you know what? I might have enough to beat him. Since I got the char- No, that's not how the charge upgrade went. I'm just kind of brain farting here. I can't remember. I think maybe I could have had enough to beat both forms of him with the Ray Sparkler without running out. But I'm not sure. Just as a precaution, I did it the way I did it. So, I killed him. The final shot has to be the Ray Sparkler. He's just talking real slow to signify that he's going to die. But he's trying to be real haunting. I don't think you can speak ellipses that slow and be dramatic. Unless it was a really, really long, awkward pause before he started exploding. Like, it's like, I will see you, I will haunt you till you die. And then 5 minutes goes by. It's just kind of sitting there. And then he starts exploding. So for 5 minutes, like, you could have done a lot of shit in 5 minutes, dude. I don't know. So then I killed him. The whole place is exploding. I got 50 seconds to get the fuck out of here before I die. And, I'm not sure how that affects everything if I die. I would imagine maybe I have to do all this shit again. Or maybe I'm just dead and I just have to, you know, just accepted, and but he's still dead, so I've accomplished something. So, since I killed the boss of this stage, this elevator works. If I hadn't killed the boss, this elevator would not work. So that's your pro tip. Almost to the end, there's going to be a little teleporter at the end, and it's going to bring me all the way back to the beginning of the stage, so I can do it all over again. And so now that I killed Vile the proper way, he won't be coming back. He's gone for the rest of the game. And once I kill Bite, who's the other optional boss, he'll be dead and he won't be coming back. Which means that there'll be two new, like if you didn't kill them, they would be boss number one and boss number two of the Dr. Doppler stages. So since I killed them, there's gonna be new bosses, which are pretty intense if you never fought them before. But once you get them, they're not so bad. Especially the second one. The second one's really easy, actually. See how fast this fucking triad blast, whatever the fuck it's called, just fucking wastes enemies? All these enemies that were so fucking annoying the first time, I just killed an entire room of enemies with one shot by just dashing around because I was invulnerable for a second and a half or so. It's intense. It's like a circus. So I'm getting to the halfway point. I have to go through pretty much the entire stage before I can get to where the sub-tank is. So I'm pretty sure you won't ever fight bit or bite in a stage that, oh, open the door with my ass. Love doing it. So here we go. Go up here to this, as I go up here to this little hidden spot where you can get a ride armor. Doesn't matter which one you get. In stands for normal, I guess. I don't know. So, drop down, boom. I'm not sure if you can open that up with like a triad charge shot or something. I would assume you can't, but I don't know. In any case, I couldn't have done that on my first try, so I had to come back. And now, we're gonna go deal with Toxic Seahorse. Which, that's the thing that's really weird about the pacing of this game, the characters that they picked out. In like Mega Man X1, you had one water themed boss, which was Launch Octopus. He didn't give you a water themed weapon. There were no water themed weapons, unless you want to, you know, roughly consider Chill Penguin as kind of sort of water themed because he's a penguin and that's sort of related. And he gave you ice, which is like water. So there you can kind of like okay, that can be acceptable. I would accept that logic. And then Mega Man X2, all you had was Bubble Crab. He was water themed, and he actually gave you a water ability. It sucked ass, but he gave you a water ability. This game, there is no water ability unless you want to count. There's no water ability really, except for the one ice attack that you get. But there are three water themed bosses in the game. None of which give you an ice attack. Only the buffalo gives you an ice attack. You gotta fight Toxic Starfish, which admittedly, Toxic Starfish is the only one in the game that actually has a water-themed level rather than just a water-themed appearance. But there's Vault Catfish, who's clearly a fish, even though there's nothing fishy about his stage. And then there's Crush Crawfish, who will be the last guy I fight because he's a fucking beast. He doesn't have any water theme level. Reminds me of Storm Eagle stage. Which is outdoors, kind of like an airport. But they're all fish. And none of them give you water theme weapons. Only the buffalo gives you a remotely water themed type of weapon. So weird. I hate this fucking frog suit because I can never get it to work properly. I don't know the controls properly. Like you can't just jump up off your own accord. You can only like hop forward, which are predetermined jumps. The game makes the decision themselves. It's just really stupid. It doesn't function properly. It's weird. But I need to use it to unlock this other hidden item. Because I need to come here, and there's a bunch of fans over there. Can't see them, but the fans. I'm too light to be able to do this shit with the fans. So I need to destroy the fans so I can get to this spot and get enough height so I can jump in the water. Because apparently robots can do that. And access up here. I can get the cave thing. It's another upgrade for the armor. I have no idea what the K is supposed to stand for. Basically, it's like the regular armor, except instead of hands, it gives you drills. So it's a boss. So this guy is like pretty weak. Like he's just flailing around these arms and shit everywhere, but they don't hit you. So I don't know what's going on. He's a lot less intimidating than he looks. is basically what I'm trying to say. With the big flailing ass arms going everywhere. That would actually be pretty intimidating if those arms were moving around that fast and they actually had hitboxes that hurt you. But no. I jump on the walls because ladders are for losers. Except for that one ladder that I used. And this one. That first ladder was for losers, I guess is my ultimate statement. So, should be getting to the end of this boss pretty soon. I think it's right around this. Oh, what? Almost killed myself. That would have been very anticlimactic. Because it's right there! Sometimes they deliberately design this shit in a way that's like, oh, we know you want to go fast, and we totally want you to go fast, but sometimes we're going to make it so that you die instantly if you go fast. It's like Sonic the Hedgehog. So this guy is like really easy. It's sort of like fighting Vault Catfish, but even easier. Because he doesn't fuck around with the rhythm. There's no way to like fudge it to where he starts doing all kinds of crazy shit. He just keeps doing this. And even when he lands, it's not like he shoots a bunch of undodgeable projectiles all over the screen. I think he just shoots like a little bubble. And that's it. Very intimidating. He's the most intimidating seahorse that I know. Has anyone ever been intimidated by a seahorse? I mean, really. Even a sea creature. Maybe that seahorse that was in Metalocalypse. That was pretty fucking intimidating. Now, last boss, Crush Crawfish. He's basically a big-ass crawfish with claws that are like... He kind of reminds me of Cutsman, only he's way tougher and stronger than Cutsman. So the cool thing about this stage is you're trying to find all the hidden items. They're all in the first, like, 30 seconds of the stage. They're all right at the front. So the rest of the stage, you don't have to worry about finding all kinds of crazy bullshit. So this is the K armor, whatever the fuck it is. I don't think that there's any difference between it and the other fucking ones, except that it's has drill arms. So, whatever. Pull out the triad so I can break this fucking floor. This is where the secret is. And there's the H. I think the H stands for hover. I could be wrong. I have no idea. But again, I just want to say how much I fucking love this triad attack. How unbelievably strong it is. Because all the enemies are in place for you to get, for you to hit them. Because all the enemies are, like, they're put in a way where they can hit you, but you can't hit them. And they're all really close. There's a breakable wall. There's a health up. And that's it. There's one more hidden item, but it's chip upgrade, so I don't need it. And also, if you're playing this and you're trying to find a spot to fight Vile, you can fight Vile in this stage too. But first, I gotta fight Bite. So I gotta pull out the drills, or T-Fangs, whatever. We know it's a drill. I've been programmed to exterminate you. Big ass guy. Now, it may not seem obvious from what's going on screen, but those little things that he's shooting at the on the wall are giant magnets. And so when you try to jump, they pull you off out of the air and towards them, which is right in his path. No, how can his great power be generated? How can this great power can be degenerated? I don't know what was going on. I think there's a lot of typos and grammatical errors in that. Basically, he congratulates you for kicking his ass. Because he didn't think he could do it. But basically, there's magnets on the wall. So if you don't have the air dash, you're pretty much fucked. Because when you hit, when you're gonna hit the floor, he's going to charge at you, and he's not just going to ram into you. He's going to punch you like 20 times and knock you around the stage like a fucking pinball. Now, where I just picked up that little health item, you can fall through the floor, and that's where one of Vile's teleporters is. But that fake floor won't be there unless, you know, the Vile portal is there. And it's only there when he's alive. And he's totally not. I killed him. He's never coming back ever again. So, he's dead. Now, actually, I should be being a little bit careful. Because, by the way, you can use a drill here. Can't you? Drill through this. And a couple of health, life, extra lives. I don't know why I was stuck up on that, but... Pull out the triad, that's the weakness to crush crawfish. Oh, I forgot, this isn't the final boss yet, there's only halfway point. Fuck. They put so many of those fucking doors that you fucking lose track of the pacing, it's weird. It's brutal. And you think, oh crap, man, this stage isn't even over yet, I was getting my ass kicked. How much more of this bullshit do I have to take? So the triad is going to be the weakness to crush crawfish, so maybe I don't want to spam it too much. But, you have a whole lot of it. I don't know if there's an upgrade that I got that cuts my usage in half, but I got a fuck ton of it. Here we go. What was the point of that fucking door anyway? Because it was literally like one room between that door and the boss. I'm not sure what's going on, what he's shooting at me, but those little fucking things, I don't know, banana peels, they suck ass. They make you lose grip with reality and agility. And he does a fuck ton of damage. Even with the armor upgrade, he'll do a fuck ton of damage. Especially if he grabs you. He'll grab you and just fucking chomp on your ass until, I don't know, you do a Hadouken in his face or something. I don't know. He's an asshole. Is, I guess, the point that I'm trying to make here.